I was raised in a little African village in the Ivory Coast of West Africa. The only white child, my sister and I were the only white children for a day's drive in any direction. I was literally raised by the poor. I learned how to hunt with the little African boys. I learned how to fish. I learned how to keep monkeys out of the cornfields that were stealing our corn. I was deadly accurate with a sling. First time I ever heard the story of David and Goliath. You know, you're supposed to think, isn't it amazing what God can do with a little boy and lots of faith? Me and my buddies, we thought, stupid giant.
Even though I had cried myself to sleep dozens and dozens of nights over the loss of my little friends, I thought the world was all like that. Children die, and it's a very sad, sad thing. Then I came across over here and I saw all of the food in the grocery stores and all of the medicine in the pharmacies. And I went through a rage as a teenager that they didn't have to die. My friends didn't have to die.
Poverty is not about those circumstances. Those circumstances that you see, that you smell, that you heard are symptoms of poverty. At the very root of poverty is a lack of hope. A sense of self-worth that allows me to believe that anything will ever change for me, that I deserve anything to change for me. I give up.
Anything that goes wrong, children pay the greatest price. It all spirals downward.
When hunger strikes, while adults get hungry, children starve. And when disease strikes, adults get sick, but children die.
Half my life is to go overseas among the suffering and to comfort the afflicted. The other half is to afflict the comforted, to do that with the same love.
The most powerful definition of compassion is this: your pain in my heart. A life can be launched with as little as a single kind word or a single act of kindness. Our job is not to come in on a white horse and take away all pain and all suffering. It's God's grace and God's great sense of humor that he would ever entrust a huge organization like Compassion to a guy like me.
I tell people everything I need to know to lead this worldwide ministry, I learned around the campfires in a poverty-stricken village.
The poor can teach you about love and joy and hope and generosity and time and relationships and courage and strength like you never would think if all you know about the poor is what you see on television. If you don't have a cause that can move you to tears in 10 seconds, or can move you to smiles of joy in 10 seconds, you are not fully alive.